Never a good thing to discriminate, to condemn anybody, because where you have not been, you don't know what people that have been there, what they have gone through, what they have passed through. So before you start criticizing people, learn to listen to their story. Learn to know about how they got there. Always learn to know people's story before discriminating, because if somebody discriminates you tomorrow, you will not like it. So this video is for all those brothers, all those guys, all those uncles, all those how will I say that run their mouth about, because it is not easy to be a single mother. It is not easy, because it is men like you made them to be single mother. They never wish to, they never desire to, they never bargain for it, but they find themselves inside. What do you want them to do? They should kill themselves. So give them praise, stop discriminating, and give them award, because they are strong. Hello my beautiful people, how are you guys doing today? I hope you guys are all doing great, as well as keeping safe. Compliment of the season, my beautiful people. I'm back with Once a Single Mother Part 2. But guys, today I really will be talking to the guys, to the men, to the boys, those that are always condemning single mothers. So my dear guys, my dear boys, my dear men, my dear brothers, my dear friends, remember those single mothers you guys are condemning, discriminating. It is men and boys like you that made them who they are today. I just want to advise those men, boys, guys that are always criticizing single mothers. Single mothers should be given an award. Award. Because even with a man and a woman in a house, it is difficult to take care of the home. It is difficult to take care of the family. It is difficult to coordinate the children. You can just imagine for a single woman to do all those coordination, taking care of everything all by herself. And people will still have the mouth, the guts to be discriminating them. You people should be giving them so much award and applause. Because it is men like you made them to be what they are today, single mothers. A lot of women, girls, are dying in a home because they don't want people to sticker them as single mothers. It is better for you to be sticker as single mother, live and be happy, than to be in a man's house that you don't have peace, you don't have respect, he does not respect you, does not give you, he does not cherish you. You are just there as a piece, just there as an object, as an admiro. You know, if a man loves a woman, whether the child was wanted or not, because at times maybe unwanted pregnancy, it was not planned, then the man will say, oh, I don't want to, because I not plan am, or will not plan at this and that, that and this. The woman rather keep the baby and allow the man to go than to kill an unborn child, an innocent child. It is forbidden. When we are growing up, as of them many years ago, we used to do all those things, but it's wrong, because those children are innocent. So it's better for you to have a child that you'll be proud of having a child as a woman than to have a man by your side. You can change many men, but children is your personal property for life. For those men, is an advice to you, because you might say today you don't have children, you don't have sisters, you don't have anybody that is female, so you can open your mouth and vomit whatever you like about single mothers. But remember, tomorrow you might be a father. You might have a daughter. If nobody wish for something bad, just like single mothers, they never wish to be single, but they find themselves in there out of circumstances. So they have to accept it. They cannot kill themselves. Life must go on. As far as you have children, as far as you have a child, you have to look at the face of that child and move on no matter what. So those men that put those women to be single mothers, most of them are the ones now blabbing their mouth, discriminating those single mothers, because they think they don't have anything to lose. Whatever you sow today, you shall reap it tomorrow. It does not, you will reap it, that by fire, by force, you know the loss. So you people should try to control this mouth. All this mouth you use in saying all those bad things about these single mothers, you should control it, because tomorrow, if you have a child, have a daughter tomorrow, and the daughter will grow up, and unfortunately, she might end up the way you have been condemning other people's children, then you, if I have known. It is not right. It is never too late to change. It's never too late to learn. It's never too late to correct your errors. So now it is the time for you to correct your errors, to correct your ways, to rearrange your mouth, so you will not be spitting all those things you say about single mothers. Has to be given a word, because they carry burden of two people all by themselves. I know what I'm talking about. I was a single mother, I said before. I carried burden of a father and of a mother. It is not easy. It is not easy. Whether with one or two or three, it is not easy, because it is something that is supposed to be carried by two people. Only one person is doing the whole thing, and you both have the cause to be condemning them. You people should be praising, giving them a word, clapping for them, because they are trying, they are doing all what they can to take care of their children. It's better for them to stick by their children, stay by their children, than hang up with a man that have somebody that was very close to me, very, very, very close to me. Three children she had for him, married, wedding, and everything. Her husband used to beat her up, get to a point whereby she don't even give the man, her husband, what husband and wife normally do. The man will do what he's not supposed to do to his wife. You know what I'm talking about. Force her to have that thing with him. So with that kind of a man, you think you can live with such a man? Is it not better for you to be a single mother than to stay with a man? If you are married to your husband, married to a man is supposed to respect you, cherish you, adore you, give you all the necessary attention that a woman needs. Women, we are like flowers. You have to water. So water the flower. What will happen? The flower will die. When women are single with children, they are curses, and these curses are made by men. You, the men that are opening your mouth today and condemning them, you are the cause of them being single mother. You are the cause. So remember, whatever you sow, you shall reap. Whatever you sow, you shall reap. Whatever bad thing your mouth has said about single mother, remember, a woman brought you to this world. A woman brought you to this world. You are being given birth by a woman. And you, the women you are still talking about, you will still open your kiniko according to Yoruba. You still put your kiniko inside, as we used to say in the Yoruba land, to be concerned, condemn. And you still have the guts to still condemn those people. May God have mercy on you people. So we are about to enter 2022. So whatever correction you have to make today, make adjustment, because it is never too late. It is never too late to amend your ways. Content creator wrote me on my comment section that she's a single mother, that people used to say all kinds of bad things about her, that she's always ashamed. I told her, don't be ashamed. Those people should be ashamed. Be proud of yourself. All the single mothers, you people should be proud of yourself. If nobody give you a word, give yourself a word and give yourself a kiss. Because it is not easy. So for those men that are criticizing, one day if they don't amend their ways, what they sow, they shall reap. So like I said before, we are about entering 2022. So whatever bad ways, whatever bad things that you have said before, it's not easy to be single mother. Be proud. Never be ashamed. Be proud, because the load you are carrying, that is not, is even in two, is heavy. But you, one, you are doing it all by yourself. You should stand firm with a big smile on your face. You should never be ashamed of who you are. You should be proud of who you are and be proud of your children and be proud that you are able to make a right decision. Instead of staying with a man to die, you decided to move out with your children and rather be a single mother than to die on a timely death. How many women have lost their life all in the name of they don't want people to sticker them as single mother? Sticker me as single mother, I care not, but it's better for me to live long, to live better, to live healthier than to die before my time and die and leave my children. So all the single mothers out there, keep on moving, keep on going, keep on doing the right thing and be happy and keep all the love for yourself and for your children, and God is with you all. I love you all, guys. Guys, thank you very much for watching. I really do appreciate your love and support. Stay good, stay blessed, stay safe. Merry Christmas in advance to each and every one of you. And remember to love yourself. All the single mothers. Thank you very, very much. I'm going to come your way very, very, very soon.